Hey guys, it's Josie.
Why did you do like 3, 2, 1? You cry last year when I was on the road. Hey guys, so I recently asked you all if I should start making YouTube videos, and the response was yes, and I was overwhelmed with all your guys' responses, so thank you so much for all the love on my last Instagram video that you guys all gave me. It is so much appreciated. But yeah, this is why I'm here today, and this is why I'm making this video, and I'm actually going to be basing the video off my last Instagram story, like the bullying topic, because I just have so much to talk about for that. And I am just ready to spill to everyone about what has been going on in my life and why I'm so like low-key about a lot of this stuff. And yeah, so let's just go back to when I was like kind of in middle school. When I was in middle school, that's when I started getting bullied, and I was called like ugly a lot, and like people didn't really talk about my body then. I guess I kind of developed at an early age. I got my period when I was like 10. Okay, that's really, really TMI, but whatever, who cares? Who doesn't know what a period is? But, and I started getting boobs when I was like in 5th grade, and I was maturing like really fast, and a lot faster than a lot of the other girls in my grade. And I started wearing makeup like pretty early, and just, I don't know, that was just me. And so it wasn't really like, I don't know, it wasn't really like, you didn't see this coming, because like I kind of just grew up pretty fast when I was younger. And so things weren't bad in middle school. It was just like whatever, like you get pushed around, you get made fun of, like every other kid got made fun of in middle school because I was like their awkward stage. Definitely my awkward stage. I wore blue eyeshadow. It was just a rough time for me. I wanted to dye my hair like brown and like cut it super short, and as you all know, I would look disgusting with brown hair, so good thing I never did that. But yeah, so as I started getting older, freshman year was when it really got like bad. When I was a freshman, there was a rumor that, this is where the rumor came about that all of you know about. The rumor that my dad was a plastic surgeon started when I was a freshman, and it was started by some kids in my school, and whoa, that was a wild year for me. I was so picked on that year, and so many people like made fun of me that year and harassed me that year. Any time I would go in the hall or walk in the halls, people would be saying stuff about me. Like, I remember one time I was walking to lunch with this one girl, and because I didn't really like listen to what people said. Like, I knew people would talk about me, but I didn't really like tune into what everyone was saying when I would walk by. But she was listening, and she was like, oh my god, I wish you could like listen to what everyone's saying about you right now. And that's what kind of made me realize, like, holy shit, why are people talking so much about a little freshman? Like, who really cares that much about a freshman? But, yeah, that's where the rumor came in that my dad was a plastic surgeon, where I got ribs taken out of my body, my boobs were done, what else? My face got plastic surgery. All this BS that, isn't true. For all of you that don't believe me, or didn't know if it was true or not, it's not true. So, I mean, you guys can continue to think that, like, whatever, that'd be pretty bomb if my dad was a plastic surgeon, but he's not. I did put a post up about this like a year or two ago, but that's when I wasn't. I had as many followers as I have now. But yeah, so that's not true. But people like at my school started to realize, okay, she's obviously not like plastic surgeon, and like she obviously isn't like a surgeon, and like has all this fake stuff about her. And people in my school like realized like, okay, she's not like that. There is still some people today, but we'll get into that. Yeah, so there's just like a lot that has happened in these past 4 years that really like shaped me into who I am today. And this is kind of like a deeper topic, and like a little sensitive topic, just because I've had to deal with like so much of this, and like I don't know anyone else who has had to go through this much shit as I have, and is still going through it, and it will only get worse as, like, I get more followers and everything. You just need to remember that, like, the quote by Miley Cyrus, "Forget the haters because somebody loves you," is so true. Like, my family was always there for me. I always had this core group of friends who have always been there for me ever since middle school. They've always had my back and would, like, talk back to the people who would harass me and stuff, and it just meant a lot. And having them there for me was like, oh my god, you scared the fuck out of me. That was so scary. But you just need to like realize like you're so much better than what everyone has to say about you, and just realize that what people say about you does not define who you are, and what happens to you in high school does not, like, matter in the real world. Like, you guys see where I'm going with my life compared to all these other people who are just hating and have nothing good to say about me. And okay, so continuing on how to just avoid what people are saying about you and just move on from it and not really think about it. For some reason, it didn't really bother me that much, just because I know that I'm not what those people are saying about me. Sometimes I would get like a little down about it, and I'd like cry to my mom, be like, oh my god, I'm so ugly, oh my god, people actually think this about me. Like, I don't know why I cared that much, and you shouldn't either if this is what's happening to you too. But just know that what people are saying about you does not define who you are as a person, and what happens to you in high school will never in a million years define you as a person, and how many friends you had will never define you, and who you, if you're popular or not, will never define you, what kind of clothes you wear. It's just like, high school is low-key a big joke, so just don't worry about what people have to say. And people who have stuff to say about you are already way below you, and the fact that they have to say stuff about you proves that they're either jealous, insecure themselves, have some other problems going on in their life that they can't contain, and they have to take it on you, which who knows why. And just don't let that get to you. It was just really nice to have my mom there for me, because she would always be like, you know what, don't listen to those fuckers, like, they don't matter. You are a beautiful person, and you are so much more than what those people have to say about you, so just ignore all that shit. Some other things that has happened to me, I remember, like, because freshman and sophomore year were probably the worst for the bullying. When I was a sophomore, there was a lot of, like, Twitter shit that would be said about me, and, like, because stuff on Twitter is, like, very public, and a lot of people would see it, a lot of people would retweet it and look at it, and some of the things that were said was, like, oh my god, she photoshops her body so much, and that there was stuff like that, and then there was a lot of stuff, like, I don't know, just, like, calling me out and saying how I'm, like, just this bad person, and like, oh my god, I remember one time actually, this kid who I, whatever, they're irrelevant now, but they like put up a picture of me without any makeup on, and it was from like, I don't know, 9th grade, and that picture blew up, like it got like 60 retweets and a bunch of like likes, and people were like, haha, that's the real Josie Lentner, and all this stuff. And I remember this girl was like DMing me the other day, and she's like, and she sent me the picture, and she goes, is this really you? Shut the hell up. Don't bring that shit up from 9th grade. Like, that's not funny anymore. And also what's not funny anymore is the plastic surgery jokes, because those are so old. Like, if you're gonna make fun of me, like, at least have, like, a better joke now. One that isn't used so often, and one that's actually, like, real and not just made up and full of shit. And, but yeah, that was another thing that was said about me. And then, oh boy, there's this one girl who, we aren't gonna name any names or anything, but, she put up, we were like friends at one point, and then I don't know, one day this flip like switched, and she put on her Instagram a picture of like us, and the caption was like, TBT to the day that she stuffed her bra with socks and they fell out and everyone saw. And so she put that on Instagram, and then I remember she would like prank call me, and she would be like, what's that mole on your forehead, are you an Indian? And she would be like, stop photoshopping yourself so much, get some braces, fix your teeth, what else would she say? Oh yeah, stop being such a cake face, like take off that makeup. She would just say such rude shit to me, and the funny thing is, like, I never said anything back to her. Like, I remember I would get all these like texts harassing me from like, it wasn't even from her phone, because I blocked her, and it would be like from her friend's phone. I don't know how the fuck, like, why is she still trying to be in contact with me if she hated me so much? But I remember I would get those texts, and I would just be like, leave me alone, like, seriously, like, do you have nothing better to do than just like keep talking about me to everyone and all this crap? So just, and I don't know where the fuck she is now, I don't know what she's doing with her life, but I don't care to know. And so that's like the funny thing. And The one thing I do remember about her though, she was a very insecure person, and I remember she would like wake up like super early in the morning to put on a lot of makeup. Like, there's no hate on putting on a lot of makeup, I do that too, but like she would just wake up super early before I even woke up and like cake her face and just, like, she didn't want me to see her without makeup, but she would make fun of me without makeup, and it was just a bad situation. We're done talking about her because she's irrelevant. But anyway, the main reason I was Barbie was because I get told I'm plastic all the time, so I just wanted to embrace that this year and actually be a plastic, so. But yeah, I'm trying to think of what other bad things have like happened, because there's just like so many that it's hard to like remember them all. So the people at my school that still have the audacity to make fun of me, like, we're literally seniors, like, why have you not grown up by now? I will walk by them in the halls and they'll be like, oh my god, she's so hot, and be like, oh my god, Josie Lentner, like, making fun of me and like mocking me and like all that bullshit, and this is literally my face. I'm like I literally don't say anything back to them because like, who the fuck, like, I don't even know who you are. Okay, I know who they are, but like, who gives a fuck what they have to say about me? Like, I'm not gonna see you guys after graduation, so why the fuck should I care what you're saying about me? Frick. A lot of people have kind of realized like I'm not who they think I was. People know that I'm not this like fake ass, and even if I was a fake ass, like, who cares? It's none of your business. So okay, we focused a lot on the cons. We just me. I focus a lot on the cons of bullying, but there's actually like a lot of good things about bullying. Not like people make fun of you, but like, because I've gotten bullied, I am so strong now. Like, you guys don't even know. Like, people will say some shit to me, I'll be like, shut the hell up. But, yeah, I'm just so much stronger now, and I'm just so much more confident in myself. Like, when I was first getting bullied, I could have never sat in front of a camera and been like, hey, just because, like, I would just been like, people are judging me, like, I'm the wazoo. But, like, I'm totally confident now. And there's just like so many things that have like happened to me that are like amazing, that because people talk shit about my Instagram or about who I am as a person, it doesn't add up to all the amazing opportunities I've been given because I have this amazing base on Instagram, or I have the looks I have. Like, there's just so many good things that have happened to me, and it just outweighs all the bullying that has happened to me. And I know that the longer I stay on social media, the more followers I get, it'll only get worse, but sis, you gotta stay strong. You can't let those fuckers hurt you, because they don't matter. The only people that matter are ones that love you, and if people are gonna make fun of you, like I said, they're already below you, they're self-conscious about themselves, like, just don't let them get to you, because they don't matter in the real world. And if they did matter, they wouldn't be saying stuff like this about you. If you guys are ever feeling like super down, I don't want to sound like a suicide hotline or anything, but I'm here. I'm a resource you guys can talk to. Like, I'm very good at responding to all my messages that everyone sends me. And if you guys ever really need someone or someone to talk to or just tell and vent everything to, I'm here for you, okay? I want you guys to know that I will help you get through this, because I got through it all by myself. And you can too. That's you. And what else should I say? Another good tip for dealing with this is never to bottle up your emotions, because that will just make everything so much worse in the long run. Like, I remember after every incident that would happen to me, I would go straight home to my mom, I would tell her, I would vent to her, and then she would just like get it all out. And I think that's why it didn't bother me so much, because I just got it all out right away, and I just like stopped talking about it. I'll make more videos in the future focusing on like specific topics, like specific bullying topics, and we can talk more about it if you guys want me to, rather than just this vague overview, because I was like low-key nervous for this. I didn't know what I was really gonna talk about. So yeah, my next video or a few videos later, we'll talk more in depth about this, but I just wanted to let you guys know a little bit of my past and how to kind of get through it. And you, if you need me, I'm here, sis. Like, we tight. Thank you so much. If you watch this, it means so much to me, because you guys are just the best. And thank you so much for the love you gave me last week for my last video. And I love you all. Peace and blessings.
Fuck with, fuck with, girls like you. Fuck with, fuck with, fuck with, girls like you.